Hey, what's up, guys? Josh here. So, Fostex TH900 Mark II Sapphire Edition. I've got some thoughts on this thing. I don't think there's any departure in terms of sound, basically anything but the actual cup color compared to the standard red Mark II version. And the Sapphire Edition is actually an anniversary edition. If you do want to pick this up, there's going to be a link to the red version down in the description. It's a $1,600 closed back headphone. So it's actually on its way currently back to the owner of it. It came from a guy named Nima. Nima has been a huge friend of the show. Thank you very much, Nima. I appreciated listening to it. Now, this is the last review of Nima's products that I'm going to do, at least of the batch that he sent so far. And it's actually the review that I had to wait the longest towards because I can't actually listen to this headphone for very long. Like, it takes me about 20 minutes to develop a pretty severe headache from just listening to it. And there's something sort of in the treble response. I tried EQing different frequencies in the treble to see if I could get something that wasn't so irritating to me, because when you listen to it, it's kind of a V-shaped headphone, but the treble is really, really, really forward. And I think it was just the forwardness of the treble that was only allowing me to get like 10 to 15 minutes of listening time. So I had to kind of stretch that out over time, and I couldn't do big chunks of listening like I normally do. So I'm basically waiting to the very last minute to review it. So we'll talk about sound more in a second. Now, first on the build quality, the cups are absolutely beautiful. They are gorgeous cups. There's no denying that. But the build quality is something that... it's the same as the lower end models, which is great for the lower end models, but the upper end models of the Fostex line, it makes it not really feel like you're getting a premium product over something like the THXO Ebony or the Mahogany, for example. Those just have different cups, but essentially they're exactly the same build and they both come with quality cables. And so you don't really feel like you're getting this really premium product from Fostex, even though they are undeniably beautiful. They're very unique looking. And they are well built, but they don't really stand out to me for $1,600. So for sound quality, this actually marks the third high-end closed-back headphone that I reviewed recently. So you've got the Z1R, which is still probably my favorite. Then you have the Fostex Mark II, and then you have the HD820. Now the TH900 Mark II stood out to me, but for all the wrong reasons. It is really bright. What do I mean by really bright? I mean really, really, really bright. Like, gave me a headache, gave my friend a headache. If you are treble sensitive, this is probably, I would say, the brightest headphone that I think I've ever listened to. I'm trying to think of another bright headphone that might be comparable, but like the people who think that the 1990 is bright, this headphone is way brighter than that. People who think the 800 is bright, this headphone is way brighter than that. It is a bright headphone in the treble response. Now, it's got a decent amount of kind of body and girth to it because of the quality of the bass, which is actually quite good. The bass is surprisingly good, actually. And it's unique from other Fostex. So the THXO Ebony, which I still think is a great purchase for bass response. I'm hoping that they come back with it. If you can, try and pick it up on the used market. I think it's a great product. You get a fantastic build quality, same as their higher end models. And the bass response for the price is excellent, but it's kind of like a bubble for bass response. So it's got a ton of sub bass, got a ton of mid bass, and a ton of upper bass, and then decent vocals actually. And then kind of a little bit boosted from the vocal area, but it's got a little bit boosted treble response. So it's still a V-shaped headphone, but I think that headphone is actually done really well. This headphone basically skips the bloat of the mid-range that I think if you were to take a more technical analysis of the Ebony versus the Mark II, you definitely see some bloat and some muddiness in the bass response of the Ebony, as should be expected given the price difference. But the Mark II kind of skips the bloat and the bubble of the bass response and just hits super cleanly everywhere. And like all the way down to 20 hertz. Like if you play a 20 hertz tone in music, it is just incredibly obvious. And that's one of the benefits to the driver that they're actually using in the Mark II here, is the resolution capability is actually pretty astonishingly good. And even though it's a bright headphone, even when you skip all the way over to the treble again, you're still getting just incredible resolution and incredible details without sibilance. It's bright as fuck, but it's not sibilant. And to kind of complement the treble a little bit, there is an astonishing amount of information that can be taken away from the treble response but it's at a pretty severe cost in my opinion. So it's not really something that I enjoy, nor is it something that I recommend, unless you don't have much hearing above like 5K. Like if you're really hard of hearing in that area, this headphone can be totally recommended. Or one specific use case that the owner of this uses it for, which I can understand, but I can't recommend, nor would I do it for myself for the cost, but that's using it for just dark music. And I actually have a specific example of this. So the Skyrim soundtrack, for whatever reason, the actual game music, like in-game, is really distorted. And if you go to like Spotify or Google Play, you will only find really poor distorted versions of that song. It doesn't sound very good, doesn't sound very clean. I wish I could find the files of the source that I have, but I know they're out there, but there is actually really high resolution quality files of that don't have any of that kind of in-game music distortion. And that music is actually really well recorded, like surprisingly good, but it's mixed kind of dark, right? It's not a very present in the top end type of mix. And with this specific headphone, that soundtrack has never sounded better. The bass response of it, the depth and the field of it sounds amazing. But most importantly, the inherent treble boost of the TH900 actually benefits this track to feeling incredibly detailed and vibrant in the top end and just mix really well with it. Now, is it worth, you know, $1,600 to hear one specific album or a couple specific albums in, you know, the best versions of them? Maybe, but not for me. But that's up to you. You're an adult. You can do with your money what you will. I could kind of understand that perspective, but as an overall headphone, I don't think I could recommend it. Now, I haven't really talked much about mid-range, and that's because I find it pretty unremarkable. In the lower mid-range, it's not really super well separated. It doesn't have this great level of definition that something like the Z1R has. I think the Z1R has incredible presence for the vocals despite being a V-shaped headphone, but the S region is punishing. It is violent in that region. It is incredibly forceful and kind of pelts you with the S's and the T's, and they're just piercing. They're sharp, and that's on top of the other treble issues that, you know, if you play anything with a decent level of treble in it, you are going to get absolutely shredded. Now, this leads me into an area that I actually am sort of complimentary of, and that's going to be the imaging and soundstage capability. It's really good. I think the problem is, and I'm not sure what kind of the thoughts that the tuner of this headphone had and the designer of the sound had in this headphone, but I can't tell if the treble response is as bright as it is as a result of them trying to match kind of a certain target on a graph, or if it's to kind of create a better and arguably very impressive soundstage and imaging capability. I don't know where they were going to it. And I'd actually like to talk to them about it, although, you know, talking to them about why they made their headphones so terrible is probably not something that they're willing to do. But where it would place the imaging and soundstage is really high, actually. For $1,600 close back, it's pretty good. It's not quite as good as the 820, but it's better than the Z1R. And I actually quite like the imaging and soundstage capability. But unfortunately, again, it's still a punishing headphone. So I think that's going to wrap up my conclusion of this. The Fostex TH900 Mark II Sapphire Edition, The Punisher, is going to be probably the title of this review. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up. Please like the video if you like it. Now, also, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. I'll try and get to them. If I can't, maybe somebody from the community can. Visit the t-shirt shop, Patreon, all that fun stuff. And until the next review, my name is Josh, signing off.